woke up with enough time to make it to church. The 9 a.m. service. Look at me. I was FaceTiming my sister this morning, so I didn't really show me getting ready or anything, but I was FaceTiming her as I got ready. I just threw on a quick little makeup look, and then I'm going hiking after, so I had to like bring all of my hiking stuff with me. Well, mainly just like my change of clothes for after I get out of service, because I'm gonna leave from service and go straight there. Ooh, excuse me. And then I should be good. So I just have to get gas, get to church. I brought all of my snacks and everything. I didn't have time to make breakfast, but that's okay. I usually don't eat breakfast like that anyways. Oh, yes, gas dropped another 2 cents today. And also, like, the hiking trail we're gonna do shouldn't take us more than 2 hours, so I'll be able to still come back home and do Instacart, hopefully, because they have a promotion where if you just complete four batches, you'll make $56. So I'm definitely gonna try to do that, since I did not make as much money this week doing Instacart as I usually do. So there is an update on all of that. Oh my goodness, you guys. It is so freaking cold out here. I've also been up since like 6, a little bit before 7, basically. And it was probably for the best. I wasn't planning on getting up until 8, but my body woke me up at almost 7. Probably because I went to bed like around midnight, so I feel like the older you get, the less sleep your body tells you you need. So as long as I get at least 6 hours of sleep, my body's like, you good. Anyways, I feel like it's gonna be such a beautiful day, a great day for a hike. I brought the best shoes that I could for the hike, which are my Toms boots that I showed you guys yesterday. So hopefully those are gonna work well for this hike. I really don't have any other options, so yeah. Or leave it. Let me wait for this car to park. Okay. Y'all, I forgot my change of clothes, so I gotta walk back. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to walk all the way back and back in again, which I don't wanna do.
It was Georgetown. Over a fourth.
All right, you guys. So I got out of church and I had to like leave a little bit early because service went a little bit longer than I was expecting. And I went to the bathroom, I changed. So I have on like my workout clothes now. And I am headed to the park. I am going to be drinking my Celsius Peach Vibe since I've been up since like for a minute this morning. And then I have my protein bar that I'm gonna eat since I have not eaten at all before coming here. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll see y'all when I get there. Alright, bye. Y'all, this view is so pretty. I really love the views you get to see on hiking. That's what I love about it. And I haven't been in so long. Look how freaking nice it is. Alright, y'all, we made it. But I guess you have to stop and pay for parking. I'm not sure how much that's gonna cost. Hopefully not a lot. I think that might be Nana behind me. I can't tell. But I definitely don't have, I hope it's not a lot. Yes, I have bug spray. All right, y'all. I put on my little boots that I decided to wear, and they're really comfortable. So I think I'll be good, honestly. My other friends have their hiking boots, but I think I did the best with what I have. And then I was able to use the restroom first because I drank my whole thing. Well, I'm still trying to finish it. And it says it accelerates my metabolism and burns body fat, which is what we need before we do this hike. So I'm so excited. Oh, Nana's set is so cute. All right, y'all. We need to find this start of the trail. Most people don't carry cash anymore. That's so mean. I mean, he's... Okay, let's make sure we're starting the right one. What's it called?
A follower.
Yeah. Okay, apparently the view over there is really pretty.
Okay, Cookie, we're just gonna keep.
but you have to climb over the fence to get it. Well, they literally, it looks like they used to allow people to go back here. All right, Cookie, let's do it. Wait, you're gonna have to, Come on. Y'all, the peer pressure I just experienced. Oh my goodness! Okay, this is worth it. We need pictures.
It's really pretty, right?
Yeah, we broke rules to get this view. This is going in my vlog. I miss being on the swing. I am 26 years old and on a swing because that's the type of person I am. And it's so fun. So this is where the really good views are. And all along this trail too. I think where they're at is really nice. Ooh. Oh, that is nice. You can see everything. Wow. I think I would be low-key scared though to do the one that's down there.
Outfit. 2,000 years later.
All right, you guys, we finished the hike in about 2 hours, mainly because we like stopped and took pictures and ate lunch, but it was only like a 2.5 mile hike, which I honestly could have done in less than an hour if we were like moving quickly. But it was really fun, and we're gonna come back and try to do a harder one in 2 weeks, which I was just nervous to do it today because you need to have like a good pair of boots, and it's a red level hike, which means it's extremely difficult and rugged terrain. So I was just really nervous and not really mentally prepared to do it, but they want to come back in another 2 weeks and do it. And also earlier today, my friend called 911 on my phone because we heard like, it sounded like someone was screaming for help down in like the ravine, because the place that we went is called the Mini Grand Canyon, because it's pretty much like, it looks like the Grand Canyon, but a lot smaller, obviously. But it was really pretty, it was really nice out. And so anyways, my friend called 911, and then we had to report it to the park people who work at the park, because we heard someone calling out for help. It sounded like 3 times they screamed help, so we think maybe someone could have gotten hurt or fallen or something. So we just called to make sure we were safe. Better to be safe, like better to call for help and not need it than don't call for help and someone actually needs it. So I'm really glad we did it, and we saw like the fire people come. They had to send down like whatever it's called, like the bike things, basically one of those like what are they called, I can't think of it, basically the like carts that can drive on terrain. I can't think of what they're called, but they got one of those out to help the person. So I'm headed back now to Columbus. I want to try to do work for maybe like 3 hours to get the promotion for Instacart today, and then I'm gonna go home, shower, and relax the rest of my night. All right, y'all, I guess got a really rude call from, I guess, like a park ranger, and he said, he was like, just really rude over the phone. He was like, are you the person who called 911? I was like, no, my friend did, using my phone. He was like, oh, well, did you not tell anybody when you called 911? I was like, we literally told someone at the visitor center, like the person on dispatch told us to. And he was like, well, who did you tell? I was like, well, it was a lady who worked there with shorter brown hair who wore a green shirt. And he was just like, yeah, something, something, something. And then he hung up. I'm just like, why would you call? And then he like accused us. He was like, y'all made a call and you're the only 2 people who heard this person calling out for help. And I'm like, no, it was like a whole group of us. One who heard screaming, and then we even saw these other 2 girls, and they said they heard them too, but they didn't think they were saying help. But we heard someone yell like really, really loudly 3 times, and it sounded like it was coming from the trenches. So I don't know, the guy was on one when he called me, and I was like, there's no need to be rude to someone like that over the phone. And he was blowing up my phone. Mind you, I'm driving, so I'm like, I wasn't trying to answer my phone from like an unknown caller. But then they kept calling me, so I like answered back. Rude. All right, y'all. I am super freaking pissed because I bought a water bottle yesterday from TJ Maxx that I took hiking today. Tell me why, like, I have the lid on the water bottle is not secure, like, at all. Every single time I would hold it, the lid would just pop off and separate from the bottom. And I'm telling you, I twisted it tight. and I just tested it, and I can still pull it. I can pull the lid off no matter how tightly I twist it. So I literally dropped my bottle 3 times because the lid is, what's it called? Damage or something. It's just like it doesn't work properly. So I'm gonna probably take it back to TJ Maxx and see if I can get a return for it, because I'm gonna be like, no, this is a damaged or defective water bottle if the lid just pops off no matter how tightly I put it on. Like, you shouldn't be able to just pull the lid off of a water bottle no matter how tightly you do it. Anyways, I need to do 3 more Instacart orders to get the promotion. So I got my second order. Hopefully I'm done by 6:30, y'all, because I'm honestly tired. I've been up since like 7 a.m. It is now 5 p.m. And I honestly just want to go home and lay down and take a nap. Also, did I mention I have to go to court tomorrow for the ticket I got for, I guess it's called a bus arm violation. So I'm gonna go tomorrow and hopefully get it dismissed, because I literally would never intentionally ignore a school bus stop, or not stop for a bus. I'm gonna be like, first of all, I never saw the school bus stop arm. Y'all, I'm tired and my stomach hurts. And I'm also very freaking annoyed. All right, so I have a headache, and I think part of it is from my hair, and then the other part is from not wearing my glasses. Either way, it sucks. It probably doesn't help that I didn't drink a lot of water, because I kept spilling my water in my water bottle. I just realized I'm probably hangry. I have not eaten an actual meal all day. So I accidentally did a fast today. Y'all, I made $84 today. I'm so tired and I'm so hungry, and I just want to go home. $84 in 3 hours. So that's like over $25 an hour, mainly because of the promotion. And my first order paid like $21. So I'm done for the day. I can now go home and relax. And I've never been happier. Okay, bye. I feel like Zaxby's just needed to give me my food real quick, because I was not trying to get stuck in that freaking line in the drive-thru. I just wanted my wings, my food, and I order at a pro at Zaxby's, because I used to work there, so I already know like what things are on the menu I would actually want or wouldn't want. And and I feel really gross because, oh my gosh, I can't even see the freaking light. Well, this is not fun. The sun's shining directly into my face, y'all, but I hit my goal for the week. This particular week, I knew I wasn't gonna be able to make $300 on Instacart because of how slow it was on Thursday and Friday, but I did make $180 this week, which was $50 more than I needed to make, so I'm very happy with that. I'll take it. So minimum, I need to make $300 every single week, and I did that. So, well, very, very minimum, $250. Y'all, it's so complicated with me. My work schedule at Kohl's is supposed to be like 20 hours a week, but these next 2 weeks they've scheduled me like 30 plus hours Monday through Friday. So I will probably be doing Instacart during the week, maybe for like 2 hours every day, 2 to 3 hours every day, and try to just make my extra money during the week so I can have my weekends off, because I feel like I really enjoyed being able to hang out with my friends today, and they actually had to drive down closer to me because I usually always have to drive up to meet them, so that was really nice. This weekend that I got to just see people and socialize. So I want to be able to have like every other weekend just have it off. Of course, because Instacart is my side hustle, I do prefer being able to do Instacart on the weekends, but it's also nice every now and then to have a weekend off. So I think like just doing every other weekend doing Instacart would work out well for me. And then the weekends I do it, don't do Instacart on the weekends, I would just try to do during the weekday, which of course isn't as busy. So why do cars freaking do this? This car stopped at a freaking cul-de-sac with no car coming. And y'all, I'm just hangry. I'm tired. I've literally been out. Well, I've been up for 12 hours now because it's almost 7. And I did a lot today. I went on like a 2-hour hike. An hour away from me, drove back, worked Instacart on my way back, or started doing Instacart as I was driving back. I went to church this morning too, so it has been a very full, busy day for me, and I have not eaten. I did not eat breakfast or lunch. I only eaten snacks, so I do think a lot of my attitude slash irritability is me being hungry slash hangry, and also having a headache from not wearing my glasses most of the day. So yeah, I might end my vlog here because all I'm gonna do is eat my food, shower, and relax for the rest of my day. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. See y'all in the next one. Peace out.